I play a very, first of all, hi to everyone. I play a very egoistic girl in the film. I play a very egoistic and angry girl in the film. And I play Ramya Ma'am's daughter.
What's your character's name?
Anu. My thing.
First time you're playing a character with your own name?
Yeah, yeah.
How did that feel?
I mean, first my name was Janaki in the film.
Okay.
So that was previously, I had Janaki in my other film, Kittu Nar Jagrata. So I told my director that. That's why he changed it. Because of that reason.
How much are you related to your character?
Actually, everyone on set says I'm similar to her. Because I do have some bit of ego. I think everyone should have a little bit of ego. But I don't think I'm exactly like this character. I think a little bit like her.
So which characteristics is it that match?
Excuse me?
You said there's some elements of the traits of the character that sync with you. Which are those traits that sync with you?
The egoistic part.
Oh, you are egoistic.
But not to that extent that she is. Mm-hmm. She's extremely egoistic.
Mm-hmm.
But I would say I have a couple of shades of that, yeah.
So what was the experience of playing this character like?
It was really nice because my other films I play the kind of sober girl who doesn't speak much.
Mm-hmm.
So this one she's very loud and she screams at people. It's complete opposite of what I've done before. So I really liked playing it.
Okay, so you dubbed
for yourself? No, not in this film. Yeah.
Do you get the chance to show your acting talent?
I think I did, because Marathi sir is, he really challenges you. I think even Che also, I think you watched the trailer, right? You've seen a different body language in Che. So he also challenged me in that way.
Working experience with Che?
I'm very comfortable, most comfortable co-star.
Until now?
I think all my co-stars have been extremely comfortable, but I would say he's probably number one.
Not much.
It's mostly montages and all that. But Che did dance. Yeah.
Little bit louder, both of you.
Sure.
The voice is a bit
low. Yeah. She's, Ramya ma'am is the most graceful person I've ever seen. She comes on set and there's some kind of power when she comes. And the most fascinating thing about her is, she doesn't take the script with her. Like normally we get our dialogues before, right? She doesn't take it. She reads it there on the set itself. If it's a paragraph of dialogues, she can memorize it in 2 minutes. That's the most fascinating thing about her. She's very graceful and...
Was it intimidating to work with somebody like her? I mean, I'm sure you had a lot of scenes with her in the film, so was it intimidating?
A little bit. Actually, I would get nervous whenever I see her. Something happens to me, I don't know. Whenever she asks me something, I forget what I should say. So, yeah.
So that happened between when you had to say your dialogues as well?
No. But, you know, when she comes to me and speaks to me, I just feel like, oh my God. She has that power inside of her.
Who is the most affected person for your ego on the set?
Who is the
most affected person for your ego?
What does that mean?
For your ego nature, ego, who is the most affected person? Any affected person?
I mean,
person
who takes the brunt of your real life
ego? On the set, you're saying? On the set, my staff. They go through so much.
So the character's anger you were talking about, could you elaborate a little bit about the anger of the character? What is the nature of the anger? What is it like?
Basically, like any other egoistic person, she sees herself as the most important. She feels like she's the number one and everyone else is stupid around her. She's very prideful.
Mm-hmm.
But when she loves a lot. Because she loves very rarely. And the relationship between her and her mom is not on good terms. So, yeah.
How much it relates to your real life anger part?
Actually, I get pretty angry, but I don't think I do to this extent. This character is a bit exaggerated of my version. But I am a pretty angry person. I get angry for a lot of things.
But you are getting a lot of calls in Telugu.
Excuse me?
You said you are a pretty angry person.
Yeah.
But still you are getting a lot of calls in Telugu.
It's important to show the anger at the right person, right? So if I show it to you or the media or my director or my co-star, then I wouldn't be sitting here now. She didn't give me any.
Do you ask her?
No, I didn't ask her. Experience
with Ramya Menon, you will learn something from her?
Basically, she's been in the industry for so many years now, and it's very rare to see someone that lasts that long in the industry. So I was sharing my experiences with her because some of my movies have not been doing well, the recent ones. So we were talking something in relation to that, and she said sometimes you cannot control those things, because if a film is hit or flop, that's not under my control. So she said just enjoy the process. That's something that stood with me. Enjoy the process of filmmaking, because you cannot do anything about your film being hit or flop. So that's...
Do you regret anything, like some of your films supposed to be released 3 years back, they're released now? It's all like flops continue because of those films.
No, nothing like that happened.
Because Oxygen supposed to be released.
That was the one film.
Rajasthan film also, I think.
Oxygen being released late was a plus point for me, because Majnu became my first release. If not Oxygen would have been my first release, then how would I get a film with Pawan sir and Allu Arjun? But sometimes you cannot control anything. It just happens. That's how the industry is.
But you disappoint on yourself, like when the film...
Of course. I go into depression, honestly.
How do you...
Like, what do you do? Like, before film and after film, when you got the result?
It's a stressful thing, because it's like you're going for an examination each time. And
so you're nervous before the release?
Extremely nervous. And if it doesn't do well, then your offers in the film industry will be lowered. People will think of you as something else. So it's just a constant, every time you do a film, it's a very nervous thing for me.
Is that a pressure? Like, you know, just talking about how the offers can wane away just in case, you know, film doesn't do well.
Yeah.
Is that something which is at the back of your mind all the time when you're working on a film or when you're signing something new? Because it's a tough decision to make, because you never know there's a film. So how is it you make that decision?
I mean, all I do is I look at the film, see if... When Agnyatavasi came to me, when Allu Arjun's film came to me, when you look at that film, that's like, oh God, you're so lucky to get that film. Like Pawan sir, Trivikram sir, a really good banner. How can anything go wrong, you might think, right? So those things are not in my control. It's just maybe this is going to be a plus point for me after 2-3 years. Because there's a lot of actresses like Shruti Hasan also, like she didn't do well in the beginning. So you have to fail in order to succeed, I feel.
So how do you think you're faring? Do you think you're doing well, or do you think there's a long way to go? What is it that you, where do you see yourself?
I think I'm just starting out. I think this is a time where I should make mistakes and learn. Because if I make mistakes later on, I don't have time for that, right? I'm very young, probably the most youngest in the industry. So it's I feel like this is a good learning experience for me.
So what's coming up?
Because of big projects, big stars, big directors.
Which one?
Agnyatavasi.
I heard the script of Agnyatavasi, then signed it. But the obvious reasons is Pavan, Power Star Pavan Kalyan and Trivikram, right? That's the obvious reason. But I heard the script before. Because I didn't want to be like, I know his Tarantiki Ki Dariri was, Pranita didn't have nothing to do in that movie. She was nothing in that film. So I asked Trivikram sir, like, will I be another Pranita in that film? So he said, no, you won't be. You and Kirti has this equal role. So then I signed it.
You know, the film drew some flak for having the female characters, you know, they were kind of misogynistic. What did you think about that? And there were a few scenes which, you know, which had those shades. What did you have to think? I mean, when you were doing it or later, I mean, did you think of, I mean, when later people started talking about it, did you have any reflections on it?
Sometimes commercial films require you to play dumb characters. That's just how it is. And I feel like as an actor, you need commercial films and performance-oriented films. So it's a movie, it doesn't have to be realistic. If you play a dumb character, that doesn't mean Anu Emanuel is actually dumb, right? So, but people, a lot of people said bad things about me and Kirti. And look where Kirti is now. Mahanati. So one good film, if a director gives you one good film, your life is set.
So you're a waiting fan?
Yeah, of course.
Don't decide on your own, or you will ask somebody before you sign up.
One second, excuse me?
You are supposed to do Kitar Kulu.
Yeah.
Happened.
Yeah.
What happened actually?
I was doing Na Peru Surya at that time. Actually, Geeta Govindam came to me first, then Na Peru Surya came. So I was in consideration for a lot of films. And at that time, Arjun Reddy didn't release. And I heard the script, I really liked it. Shailaja Reddy, everything was like happening at the same time, so I couldn't do it. So then the director insisted, you have to do a cameo at least in this film. So I did a cameo. But I didn't see the film yet, but I heard it's doing really good. So, kind of regret not doing it.
Extremely good, not really good. The film
extremely good. Good. Okay, extremely good. You were asking something before?
No, you signed on your own decision you will take, or you will ask the main agent, or you will ask your well-wisher, or you ask somebody before signing it, because you are not well with the language. When the director narrated the script, How do you take it that you understand the script?
I can understand Telugu. I can speak also a little bit. I take my own decision. A manager doesn't involve in nothing. And he only manages me. So he's someone who just says, Anu, there's this film. Do you want to do it or not do it? Then I listen to the script and I take my own decision. I don't even tell my family members about it.
What would you consider acceptable?
I think everything, because one doesn't stand alone. If you have a good director and a bad banner and a bad hero, then it won't be a good film, right? So I feel like I look at everything.
So there are bad heroes?
Controversy.
No,
bad hero means like not in the right, like the market wise. That's what I'm saying. I'm not saying bad in that sense.
So what is coming up from your end next? What's next after Charity?
Nothing. I haven't signed nothing.
Okay. Why is it you're taking it slow?
Yeah.
We're waiting for the.
That's what I'm saying. You have to learn from your mistakes. Like I know a lot of actresses who, okay, this film is going to be finished. I have to sign something immediately. So why do you have to sign like that? I'm waiting for something good to come along.
Do you think after the release of the film, the kind of roles that will come to you will be different?
I don't want to say that.
Okay.
I don't want to say that. Huh? He's amazing because he challenges you. In my other films, I was the quiet girl. All of my films, Na Peru Surya, Agnatavasi, every film, Majnu, I didn't talk much. This film, you can see me in a different light. I don't think I should say that. There's really interesting scenes between me and Ramya ma'am. Ramya ma'am, me and Che. All of us together.
So you were talking about how the character speaks a lot in the movie. In real life, how are you? Are you talkative or are you silent?
If I don't know you much, I'm extremely silent. If it takes a long time for me to get comfortable with someone, then I'll open up. Once I open up, I don't shut up. I keep talking. Yeah.
How about, did you dabble in comedy with this?
Comedy, like when Maruti sir told me this, he said your ego is not really ego. It should be ego and comedy. People should laugh when they see that. They shouldn't be like, oh, she's so angry, she's so bad. They should laugh. So I guess there is comedy in it. Yeah.
So what are the kind of roles that you want to take up? I mean, you've done a couple of films so far. Have you figured out there's something that you still wish you're offered but nobody has come to you with such kind of roles?
I don't know. I don't think I have a dream role. I think, you know how Mahanati is something that Kirti never imagined, right? It just happened to her. But that one role took her to a different level. So I feel like that it should just come to me, something that the audience would remember me by. That's what I'm looking for.
Both are good friends, Kirti and you.
We
because
are.
You are talking more about Kirti.
Because you're very controversial. No, she's we work together, obviously. I wouldn't say we're good friends, but we're amicable. That's what I would say.
So do you see her as a competitor in that?
No, I don't see anyone as a competition.
Okay. So what is it that you, I mean, how do you perceive your contemporaries as, like in terms of your stand career-wise?
Repeat it again.
How do you perceive your contemporaries? Like how do you see them? As you said, you don't see them as competitors. So what exactly are they? Are they just like your colleagues or what?
It's just like if you're studying medicine and you're a doctor, you wouldn't see your other doctor as a competition, right? We're all doing a different film. So I don't see it as competition. I'm trying to like be better from my previous film. That's my competition. I'm trying to better myself.
So looking at your first film to now, how much do you think you've, as you personally seeing, how do you think you've grown?
I think I've improved the language. I've learned more about acting.
In terms of performance?
Yeah, I've learned more about acting. In the beginning when I came, I didn't know how to face a camera. I didn't know the language. I didn't know how to speak Telugu. And I was born and brought up in US. That is a very difficult thing. If you come from Mumbai or Bombay or something, then it's a different story. I don't even know Hindi. So communication was a big issue. So for me, I felt that was a little bit more harder than the others.
You know Malayalam?
Yeah, Malayalam I know. Agnyatavas. Mm. And Geeta Govindam, the cameo I dubbed in that. It's a plus point. Because even taking up that role was not a usual thing that people would do. I played a servant in that, and there was no songs. There's barely any romantic scenes with the hero. So I think that was a good thing.
Do you like experimental?
When the time is right. Right now I'm not in that experimental stage.
You looking for any particular character?
I don't have a dream role or nothing like that. It's just whatever the odd. At the end of the day, we're just trying to please the audience, I feel. Maybe after some years, I will try to experiment.
See, many actors say they learn something from Trivikram when they walk here. Did you learn anything from Trivikram?
You're a very. Now I have to think. He was so easy to work with. Like, you don't feel stressed or nothing. You really want to come to the shoot. He said a lot of things while shooting, like in terms of dialogue delivery and all of that. I'm sure I learned something.
Well, you know, you've been brought up in the US. You have spent major years there. So how is, I mean, you know, carrying off the Indian way of life in the movies mainly? And Indian style of dressing and stuff, did that come naturally to you or was that something you had to work towards?
Saris and everything I used to wear in US. I'm a Christian, so we go to church there. And we wear saris and go. Malayali, it's a Malayali church. But the body language and all that it was difficult for me. My body language is not how a typical Indian girl sits or walks or something. That was difficult for me. I think now it's fine. Yeah, it was difficult. Everything was difficult in the beginning.
What food habits?
Food, I liked Indian food from US also. So.
I heard you settled here in Hyderabad.
Yeah.
A house.
I didn't buy a house, I rented a house. Didn't buy yet.
He's asking when you will buy a house.
You asked me that?
No, you will not. See, if you want to settle here, obviously.
Yeah, I mean, I don't see no reason why not to buy a house here. I've been here for like 2 or 3 years now. I rarely go back to US. Hyderabad is home. Basically, it's like home.
So films in other languages, I mean, how is this? I mean, you're doing a lot of work here. Are you considering taking something there? Are you
yeah.
Here?
No, I'm considering Tamil, but I'm still waiting for the right project. Because I feel like you have to establish yourself in one industry and then move to the next industry. I feel if you do you're unbalanced in both industries, then it doesn't really work. In terms of everything, like respect also and all that. If you've made it big in Telugu, then you'll get respect in Tamil. If you've made it big in Tamil, you'll get respect in Telugu. It's I feel like it's like that. So I want to establish myself in Telugu a little bit more and then do something
in Tamil. How about Malayalam? I mean, you started off with Malayalam, and the kind of films they do there are also pretty younger, and you know, I mean, the commercial sense is completely different. And, you know, are you getting offers from there? Are you saying no to them?
I'm still getting offers from there, but the screen space is not as much as I would like. And the previous film that I did with Niven Pauly, it was a very less screen space. But they have the most realistic films in all the languages. I would like to do a Malayalam film when something good comes up. That was quick.